Hi, I'm Antonio. Welcome to This Is My Model. Today I'm joined by Pep from Aizon. Welcome, Pep.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. Tell us a little bit about Aizon.
At Aizon, we built a SaaS platform to enable the biotech and pharma industry to use AI and ML in compliance, which is relevant given the scrutiny that regulatory organizations like the FDA put on our customers.
I guess having data sets that you can exploit with ML in the pharmaceutical industry is complex, right?
It is, and we do a lot of magic in the terabytes and terabytes of data we collect and bring to S3, algorithmically detecting rogue data or anomalies that we don't want there, and bring to our customers clean data sets they can use.
Absolutely. So your company provides to your customers some platforms that goes through the full cycle of data ingestion, transformation, compliance, exploitation with ML, and visualization. Today we have here a snapshot of the ML part of it. Can you walk us through it?
Absolutely. So we built a low-code, no-code platform to allow our customers to use this data, be queried by Athena and get the data sets they want to analyze and bring those data sets to SageMaker. We're using our pharma algorithms, they can start training models.
Why exactly are you using SageMaker? What is the value that it provides to you?
It's very important. We are not tech people doing pharma. We are pharma people doing tech. And we need to focus on what's relevant for the pharma industry. Using tools like SageMaker really cut a big overhead, and we can concentrate in what brings value to our customers.
That's nice. So your customers go to your platform, which is low code, no code, and then they can basically use the data and have a set of algorithms that you provide for training the models, right, with SageMaker. And then they will serve the models using Fargate, in this case, for doing the predictions. Is that right?
That's correct.
So can you tell us an example of a use case of one of those models that your customers are doing there?
Sure. One of the processes that it's in every single biotech in the world are fermentations. We provide a set of algorithms specialized in helping our customers get optimal yields in their fermentation processes, taking into account raw material, the weather, which machinery I'm using. So being sure that those predictions bring my fermentation to an optimal yield.
Absolutely. That's a super interesting use case. I'm sure you have many more of those. But Pep, how do you see AI being used in the pharmaceutical industry?
Pharma industry is not using that much AI, at least in the manufacturing sites, given the compliance and the complexity that's there. Bringing compliant AI with qualified algorithms and validated models that they can consume easily using the API gateway facilitates the use of these machine learning models in manufacturing better drugs.
And that's a real impact. Thank you for sharing that, Pep.
It's been a pleasure.
And thank you for watching This Is My Model.